I was trained as a cancer biologist, but I think of myself as a developmental biologist because over the years it's been clear that many of the advances have been made in developmental biology. The main challenges with the treatment of breast cancer is that there are different kinds of breast cancer. And it's difficult sometimes when you study a tumor then to know which are the key genes that are driving tumor growth. So in developmental biology, we can isolate those genes and study them in the context of development and truly understand their regulation and the gene networks that they function in. With the taxpayers supporting the California Institute for Regenerative Medicine, we were able to start the Institute for the Biology of Stem Cells, and that allowed many of us to start working on stem cells at UC Santa Cruz. For me, that meant that I could start delving into the biology of mammary or breast stem cells. An organ like the breast has to have stem cells, and that's evidenced by the fact that women, when they're pregnant, can build a milk supply and over again with multiple pregnancies. And so every single time that occurs, you're harnessing the power of stem cells to grow alveoli that produce milk. Now, stem cells are mostly quiescent. They don't divide very frequently. But when they do, they give rise to daughter cells. And we believe the daughters can be very special and are important in cancer biology because different daughter cells could serve as the cell of origin for different subtypes of breast cancer. From the very beginning, I was motivated because in my own family, my sister was diagnosed with cancer when she was in high school, and my grandparents died of cancer. 1 in 8 women in America will be diagnosed with breast cancer, and 1 in 4 in the world. So it's a huge public health issue. Understanding the fundamentals of cancer biology is the key to developing new cancer therapies.